In this workshop video, I won't dive into the features and benefits of MQTT for automation. For more on that, check out opto22.com. What I will do in this video is show you how to configure the Ignition Edge software on your Groove Epic to publish Allen Bradley PLC tags to an MQTT broker using the Sparkplug specification supported by Inductive Automation's Ignition Edge. For this workshop, we'll be using the Epic Learning Center. It is really useful for training and proof of concepts. Now, if you're not familiar with how to configure an OPC UA server on Ignition Edge, please review our previous video where we configured the OPC UA server in Ignition Edge, configured an Allen Bradley PLC device driver, and installed the MQTT module. Here are the steps we need to do for this workshop. First, we'll configure the MQTT transmission module in the Ignition Edge gateway, where we'll specify an MQTT broker to publish our PLC tag data to. Then we'll launch the Ignition Designer tool. Next, we'll create the required folder structure for our PLC tags, and we'll drag our tags from the OPC browser into the appropriate tag folder. Finally, we'll commit our configuration and publish our tags. So let's get started. Log into your Groove Epic by going to your favorite browser and typing in https://, and your hostname or IP address. From the Groove Manage home screen, click on Ignition Edge. Click Sign in the top right corner. Now, if you've not changed the default and username of password and admin, I highly suggest you do so now. And you can check out our previous video for those steps. Now, let's configure an MQTT broker where we'll publish our tag values to. To do that, click on the Configure tab. Then look for MQTT Transmission at the bottom left, and then click on Settings. Now, if this menu option is not here, you first need to enable that module. Check out training.opto22.com for how to do that. Now select the Servers tab. Let's delete the example server that's here, and then we'll create a new one. Let's name it Opto MQTT Broker. The URL for your broker must be in the following format: TCP:// and then the hostname or IP address of your broker, followed by a colon and then the port number of the broker is listening on. In this case, it's 1883. For secure connections, it would be SSL and the port number would be 8883. Next, choose the correct server type. The choices are Chariot, which is an enterprise-grade MQTT broker by CirrusLink Solutions, MQTT Distributor, which is an optional MQTT broker that's integrated into the Ignition Enterprise platform, Third Party, which covers other brokers, and AWS Greengrass for Amazon. For this video, we'll choose our Opto MQTT broker type, which is Chariot, hosted at a server named called chariot.groove.com. If authentication is required, fill in the username and the password twice. Lastly, come down to the bottom and click Save Changes. Now, let's use Ignition Designer to build the tag folder structure that MQTT Transmission requires. To launch Designer, we need to open up a TCP port on the Groove Epic firewall. So let's head back to Groove Manage. Select the option to enable Designer and click Save up the top. Note that after we're done with Designer, we can come back here and disable access and close this TCP port. Back to Ignition Edge, launch the Designer by clicking on the big green Launch Designer button in the top right. This will download a small configuration file to your computer that we'll use to launch the Java-based Designer tool. If you do not have Java installed on your computer, you'll get a dialog box with a link to download Java. Otherwise, the designer will launch, click through the dialogs until it's open on your desktop, like this. Now, there's a lot of cool features and capability available here, but we're just going to focus on configuring our ABPLC tags for MQTT publishing. Let's start by creating the required folder structure that MQTT Sparkplug uses. That folder structure consists of three nested folders: Group ID, EdgeNote ID, and Device ID. You can name them anything you like, but the structure is really important. The top folder is Group ID, then the EdgeNote ID under that, and lastly, the Device ID. Start by expanding the All Providers folder, then the Edge folder, until the Edge Node folder is revealed. We'll add our MQTT tag folders under here. Right-click on the Edge Node folder and select New Folder. Here we create the Group ID folder. The Group ID can be anything you like, but generally it's an identifier for the vendor or gateway where the devices are connected and the tags are being published from. I'll use Groove Epic. So now any devices connected to this Groove Epic will fall under this Group ID folder. Next, we'll create the EdgeNode folder by right-clicking again, selecting New Folder. The EdgeNode ID folder can also be anything you want, but generally speaking, this is typically used to identify the location where the Groove Epic is installed. So I'm going to put Opto Workshop. Now, the last folder is the Device ID, and it's typically used to identify the device or the PLC. Before I continue here, let's open up the OPC browser to see all of our previously configured PLC tags. To do this, click on View, Panels, OPC Browser. This will open up a new floating panel for the Ignition Edge OPC server. Expand the folder until we see Devices, then click on that. Now choose the device that we want the tags from. In this case, it's the ABPLC. Click again and you'll see all of the PLC tags. Now we have two options here. Option one, we could just click, drag, drop this entire ABPLC device tree over the Node ID folder and all of our tags from our PLC, including diagnostic tags. This also creates the Device ID folder and populates all of the tags all at the same time. And at this point, we'd be done. However, your PLC may have hundreds of tags, and so we may want to be more selective of which tags we really need to publish. The nice thing is we can just right-click and delete this folder. All of the tags will go, and we can start again with option two. Here's what we do. We simply create the Device ID folder in the same way as the others by right-clicking, Add Folder, and name it, say, ABPLC. Then we'll just select the tags we want published, and we can drag and drop just those tags into our newly created Device ID folder. Now, the last thing we need to do is publish that folder structure to the MQTT broker. You do this by expanding the MQTT Transmission folder and the Transmission Control folder. Here, you'll find a checkbox named Refresh. By clicking this box, we will send all of the folders and tags up to the broker. Now, you might get a pop-up message here stating that Designer needs to be in write mode, so go ahead and give it permission. Now, note that the box will check and immediately clear. That's completely normal. Also note that you need to perform this last step if the folder and tag structure change, like if you add new devices or change the tags. Now, because this is MQTT with Sparkplug, data will be published only on change, otherwise known as report by exception. Now, this saves a lot of communications overhead. So there you have it. We are now publishing our AB PLC tags to an MQTT broker using Sparkplug and Inductive Automation's Ignition Edge built into the Groove Epic. Be sure and check out our other videos at opta22.com. Cheers, mate.